trip with them. I also like how there comes some of the subtle differences in nerfing these guys. Because this guy used to be an archer. Yeah, used to be
oh, there's another one, another archer over on
the oh, there's an archer. I mean, there used to be there were two archers, so it was hard to duel with one of them. The other guy would pick you off.
Let's see, where is he?
That's right there. You're actually right on him. Yeah, I think you knock him far enough, he can't draw a bead on you.
Which is the important thing.
Yeah.
Let's see. Oh, one of these guys.
Yes. And after you deal with the first one. Because, yeah, the rapier's a good choice for it. Okay, so here's our decision. You can use the rapier, although it's over half depleted now, and the number of hits you're going to be doing with it are going to break it even faster. You can kill these guys with it. You know, one combo will get them, and you have the stamina for that one combo, so you can fight them. Or you can bring the torch, and they'll run away from the light.
For now, let's do this.
Yeah. They won't run away forever. You can see them start to... they start freaking out about it. Like, they start, you know, writhing and ready to attack you, then they'll stop, or they'll stop running.
Yeah, I like the idea of combining the both,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, using it to get the advantage.
Yeah, yeah. That makes sense. Oh, the angle we knocked that the Varangian to is like he can shoot you from there, but he can shoot you from here now.
Okay. Where is he? I guess he's down there.
Yep.
So that doesn't matter too much at the moment.
No. Very nice. Emit force is another attack miracle. Okay. Now.
Oh, he's. All the
us one, oh, that's oh, that that's guy. The, yeah.
Yeah. This guy I didn't bother taking care of.
Alright, and this is the place where that's full of the dark creepers or whatever. I would come back for them.
The dark creepers.
The creepers. It's a Minecraft reference, you see. Oh, he's got a bow, too. The sea bow is, I think, basically, it along with the composite bow, is a really good, it's a nice range, and basically it's a better composite bow because it has a bit less base damage, if I remember right,
mm-hmm.
but it still scales well with strength, which is a better stat in this game, and it has better reach, or better range, rather.
Oh boy.
Remember, they have to fight a single file if you fight them on the stairs. There we go.
Stamina! Stamina!
It actually worked. I thought sure he would have hit you when your stamina was out from trying to fight behind your shield, and it would have guard broken you, but nope, it worked.
Yeah, slowly but surely I'm starting to figure out how this game works. All of a sudden?
It said about Emit Force, some painful memories from PvP.
Should I pull this?
Yeah.
Okay.
So people using that on you? I can't imagine it being that great for PvP because of the cast time on it. I think it's not as bad as it was in Dark Souls 1.
Well, if they, like, are combining forces, then...
Yeah.
Hop down here.
Uh-huh. Then one more time. Oh, yeah, or through there and down, yeah. That may actually be better. I think they put an enemy in the way now. Oh, Dark Souls 1 it was. And Dark Souls 1 had a really slow cast time, though.
Oh, it's got some of those dark enemies, though.
Yeah.
Two of them. Well, let's go the other way. Of course, watch them come out and meet me over there.
I don't think they can, because I dropped down there. I don't think they can get out, because there's a door. Right, the shadow enemies...
I can't.
Yeah, the shadow enemies used to be only in the boss room, and only in New Game Plus.
Ah.
Mm. I didn't quite make it to the shortcuts, or have to do that all over again. But now that you get most of the stuff lit, you might be able to run past most of the Varangians with a lit torch and past the spider guys.
Right.
Good again, I don't know how much aggro we're going to lose, so that's a trade-off. It's like...
That's the thing, I mean, in this game it's pretty reasonable to assume you're going to lose practically no aggro. Because they like chasing you.
Are you thinking, Fox, are you thinking Wrath of the Gods? That cast basically instantly, you got multiple shots, and it did damage? Because Emit Force had a really long cast time in Dark Souls 1.
Okay.
Unless maybe you had your dex pumped high. I know that helped with Lightning Spear. Though I mostly did the 45 dex pumping to get really fast combustions. Because when I decided to do magic at PvP, I went all out.
That you did.
Yeah. Well, you have to, because pretty much every spell that you can actually fire as a projectile can be rolled through.
That is true. Okay. Thankfully, with me not exploring as much, I should also be safe on some of the other things, too.
Yeah, if you're thinking of the caster knockdown sphere plus damage, that's Wrath of the Gods. They nerfed it bad in Dark Souls 2. In Dark Souls 1, you only had to get to Rhea in the Tomb of the Giants and then bring her back, which wasn't too bad. In Dark Souls 2, you either have to be in your third cycle, and you buy it from the NPC halfway through the game, you know, in Dragonlea Castle, or you have to get, I think it's rank 2 or 3 in the Way of the Blue, the Covenant Nobody's In, because you have to burn consumable items to rank up and then duel. So, yeah, there's probably only a handful of people in the entire world that have Wrath of the Gods in... Alright, I think that's my cue.
Yeah.
Poor Ben.
I forgot there was another Varangian that dropped down.
No Man's Wharf is rough.
Ah, well.
Well, I'll tell you what. Before we leave here and switch gears, do you want to? And actually, now we have any souls to lose. I think I will try running through the stuff and see if we can get to the shortcut.
Right.
So the easy way to do that would be all the way through here,
around the dog, around the Varangian.
Oh, that's right, it's a left stick.
Up the stairs. Up the other stairs.
Kick the can around the man. Mousetrap. Hey guys, don't mind me. It's bringing just lighting up your world.
I probably should have assumed that you knew what you were talking about with that. Oh.
A sword.
You idiots, we all have swords.
Okay. Oh. Gotta get that adaptability going.
That along with everything else that we need.
Yeah. Okay.
There should be one more in there.
Yeah, the one that didn't see us.
There we are.
Yeah, the fact those guys have no poise and we still can't stagger them out of those combos, that's obnoxious.
That is pretty rough, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, so the ringing of the bell brought that ship in?
Yeah.
Okay.
And...
there was no reason to do that. There were shadows down there.
Yeah. Well, there are, but I'd rather fight them down here. Ah, so I'm going to get the backstab.
You can backstab these things?
Uh-huh.
Huh. Bleeding.
It's only invincibility frames you still get. Oh. Welp.
That makes me feel a little bit better, I'll admit.
Who builds their houses like that?
Varangians. They like being close to the water. Really close.
Ah, jeez. That was hilarious, though. Okay, but at least that confirmed that the run is pretty much cake. I just have to watch out for that one last, guy.
Right.
Oh, that sucks.
Killer shot on that archer, though.
Yeah. Oh, that's right, lighting...
Water extinguishes your fire. What?
Realism in my Dark Souls. Luckily, we have one up here I can switch to. It's probably that last guy. Okay, let's see who we're dealing with at this point. Everybody!
Just keep running.
Good grief.
So it works as long as you can keep moving.
Yeah.
Alright, I guess see if anybody still. Yep. Oh boy.
We got the whole crowd. I thought they would have gotten tied up fighting the dark creepers.
Do they actually fight?
I think they'll fight each other.
Huh.
Another not on the same faction or however, whatever term they use. This time we got both of them to aggro.
There you go.
All right. Ooh, okay. Now, yeah, let's just drop down. The one shadow is much easier to deal with than two guys. And especially, can I see him? No.
Saying, if I had known that he was down here and what to expect, I probably would have had a better chance. As I was, I had no idea what I was dealing with.
Right.
Other than apparently a ninja.
Yeah, basically. Okay, we are out of fire. So I'm just going to run and get the shortcut quick, and if we die, you know, that just sucks to be us. But at least we'll have to do all that again.
Yeah, the important thing is to get that shortcut.
Speaking of, this was not in the original game.
Really?
Yep. There was a different shortcut you could use.
There you go. Yeah, if I had known that, you know, the shortcut was like that, I probably would have tried a little bit to just make the run for it. But
right.
Then again, I probably would have gotten lost.
Oh, there's another shadow there in the pond.
Yep.
That's a cool. Oh, there's a dog. Okay. Yeah. See, I thought the guy was hunched over on all fours and running, and that would have been like a really cool way to handle that, but right. Not so much. Okay. Let's see. There are some other things on the ground floor we can get while we're down here. The different shortcut still exists. Yeah, it does, but we don't need it. Is what I was trying to say before I got sidetracked by all the dudes.
Illusory way. Mm-hmm. Well, not really illusory.
Okay. Try fog wall. Actually, this is a timely time for me to jump in, I guess, you know, to show off some of the stuff somebody might not get.
Right. Yeah, I probably wouldn't have gotten that either.
Oh, another large.
Ooh. You would think those two trunks you could open too, but they're not chests, and therefore do not count.
Right. Yeah, so if I get to jump on them, like when they're starting to wind up for the combo, then we're good to go.
Right.
Ah.
Oh, hey.
Yeah, he used to be in that, in the lair I was telling you about. Yeah, this is the shortcut. This is the one you had to use originally. Because every time you had to go up, around, across the battlements, or across the roof there, through there, and then through the guy. Yeah, it sucked.
Who are you? I.
Yeah, exactly, Fox. It's freaking illusory walls.
Gavlan wheel. Gavlan deal.
Let's see if anybody has a need wheel next to a Gavlan.
What soul? What you want?
You did tell almost near the end of the game. I never found that out on my own. What happened was I was like reading up on somebody talking about it. It's like, hey, did you know about all the secret walls in the ruined sentinel fight? And I was like, what? and then I found out that's what you have to do. Okay, we could buy this for poise. Poise is worthless in this game. Don't do that.
Okay.
And let's just buy a bunch of poison arrows to help out our tactics.
Fair enough.
And then we can get these things. I don't think we really need them.
I wouldn't think so.
Throwing knife is, you know, it's the same as it's a poison arrow. You don't need a bow to use. Right. And it seems kind of obvious. But yeah.
So he's kind of the poison guy.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Anything we need to sell while we're here? We can sell one of these.
We can definitely sell those daggers and such.
Oh, yeah. Only two of those. It's anything we have spares of.
We have a spare chime.
Oh, yeah. We sure do. We
have a spare shield.
Yeah. Let's see.
And really, you know, my thought is, at least for some of them, you know, if we're never going to actually use it, there's not much point in it.
Tell you what, sometime off screen, we'll go ahead and just sell stuff to Govlon we're not going to be using.
Oh, fair enough.
I thought we had picked up more lacerating arrows than that. Oh, there is. Yeah, sell for 6 apiece. We have 40 of them. Okay.
Right.
That's a good point, too, that the lock stones light them up. Yeah. Hurrah for wheel. Yep. Yeah.
Only one gets a rating.
Only one. If I remember right, in this game, if you rate somebody's message and they're live, they heal slightly. I think something like that.
Huh. That'd be kind of neat.
Okay, we have no fire. We'll have to bring some over here next time.
Yep.
Oh. So I knew there was another shadow, but I couldn't remember where.
Yeah, that may be the weakest aspect, but yeah, it's still good enough.
I think, was he trying to parry me?
Maybe?
Ugh. Anyway, I remember those guys very unpleasantly. One of the funniest things you can do is destroy their table.
And they are horrifically confused by this. As I suppose I would too, if somebody destroyed the table right from under me.
I knew I could trade that one. I knew we're almost done here.
Right.
And there's a couple of different ways of dealing with this. Actually, considering that we're going... Yeah, once again, we're almost done here. This is the most deliberate, you know, waste of divine power you can probably think of.
Why did you do that instead of just, like, rolling through it?
Because... That's why. Once again, we have enough Estus, so... Actually, I'll just use this and it's canceled out. Watch the health bar go up and down, up and down. Oh, that's where that is now. Okay, yeah. Awesome.
It's from that. Yeah, I want to use it again. Oh. Well, there you go.
Alright.
Oh, great.
And yeah, and then there are walls like that that you might try pushing action on, and they don't open, so you think, oh, there's nothing there.
Right.
And you have to break them. Ugh.
Yeah, if Wolfenstein taught us anything, it's that you have to have a unified mechanic for dealing with secret things.
Yeah. That is a weight increase ring. Lets us, and those things are deceptively useful. I mean, the listed benefit is obviously good. You get to carry more stuff. But the even better part of it is that by the lighter your actual load is in proportion to how much you can carry, the faster you recover your stamina. Hmm. And of course, the further you roll and stuff like that.
It is pretty useful.
All right, anyway, I think...
Are you going to get that extra soul item thingy back?
No, I'm just going to run to the bonfire and get out of here.
Fair enough. Probably a good idea.
Yeah. Now the other shortcut, we have two questions. We can... you can hop back in if you want to, or we can get to the boss. Or
do you dare?
Or we can check that last area, or we can go fight Pursuer, or we can use up one of the Fragrant Branches and go somewhere else. There's a lot of stuff we can do here.
I guess I can go ahead and try to do more stuff here.
Okay. Now that you're feeling a little more rested and everything?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay. You're giving it back to Ben, and... yeah, we can go across the shortcut straight to the boss. There's also that spot at the top of the hill with the shack full of the dark guys.
And I was also thinking that at the least I could go ahead and wake up.
Yeah.
I was thinking I could at least light a couple more sconces.
Yeah. Sounds good. Oh, and there's also the big building right in the middle of the map. We still need to go there. There's some goodies in there. Yeah, Fox was saying you got an extra Estus Flask dose, one for being raided, and yeah, that's all. Yep. Yeah, not the case anymore in 2. It would have been nice. He said that Pursuer is just the key of it's a matter of learning his moveset, and I agree. Like, you know, I tend to have pretty good luck parrying his charge attack, and of course the first time you fight him, you parry him once, and you release to him, and you're done. You know, I've done that while phantoming with people, and it's there, like, it's pretty great.
I bet that was a Counter-Strike hit, wasn't it?
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Yeah, Pursuer really isn't that bad. He's just kind of intimidating because he does a fair bit of damage, and he's like a really souped-up normal enemy. You know, he does the combos, he darts around, you know, he just sucks the fight. And
that he does.
But he is fun to fight once you get it down, though. Fight him like a man. There you go.
About time.
Yeah, if I'm in a hurry or if I'm trying to show off or whatever, I will use the Ballista. But yeah, I like fighting him normally too. It's good practice because, especially in Scholar, I think you fight him like 4 or 5 times. I run into him once an additional time. And
do we have any extra torches besides this one?
No, but you see there on the left how we have 57
minutes. Already.
So you have 57 minutes worth of torque.
Right.
Yeah, every time you extinguish it, it stops counting.
Right. Okay. Where are we going?
Okay. Well, we want to kill those guys first.
Okay.
I don't think you have to. Oh, hey, they're running for it. Yeah, I'm not sure how much time you get to deal with those guys, but it's a fair bit.
Where did the other one go?
Oh, he dropped something. I think he went up the stairs. Huh. And it's interesting, they dropped the pyromancer stuff. Oh, he went in there. It's kind of interesting they dropped the pyromancer set. It makes you kind of wonder if they were mutated by chaos magic or something.
It's possible.
Anyway, you want to go up the stairs.
Okay.
And I guess you want to get the big building first, right?
Yeah, might as well.
Okay. Watch out for the shadow. We're probably going to attack because he's like up on that, right up on that ledge. Okay, guess not. All right, in that case, through the door. And then we will go up. I think there's two Varangians in here. Yeah. Maybe just one.
Looks like just one.
Okay. Then through the, then yeah, up.
I mean, there might be another one up here. But there is. Okay. Okay.
Then through the,
was
the
there
shortcut.
A shiny
up my, no.
No. Oh, I just saw that over there.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. All right. Then we go from, we start from the top. Let's go and kill these guys. Yeah, it is cool how it gets them in two hits. That helps out quite a bit. If you actually have to fight, if you actually have to skirmish with these guys, it just sucks. Yeah, I'll just get really close and then hit the button to lock on.
Arrgh.
So I'm not expecting a... Ooh.
I was not expecting three Varangians.
Yeah.
Where one would have sufficed.
Okay, so you can go back the long way. You can go around the back way, or
well,
you can go.
I really should have just done my usual thing and shot him with an arrow.
Mm.
That's what I should have done.
Right.
Also, if we move to a different area, we lose that bloodstain, right?
If we die again, we do.
That isn't what I asked.
No, it's still there.
Depending on our. Well, I guess it's still doing okay on durability.
Under durability?
Yeah.
Every time you die or go back to the bonfire, it resets it.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, basically the only time you care about the durability is if it actually breaks.
I see. Well, fair enough, I guess.
Yeah, Fox confirms you fight him a bunch of times now. I was afraid of that. Yeah, I remember that was the original plan. Like he was supposed to, you know, pursue you throughout the game.
Hence the name.
Yeah.
Oops.
Yeah, and Fox confirms that too. The bloodstain stays until you die.
Okay.
I need to pull that guy.
Yep.
Makes sense. Yeah.
Saying so there's really no reason not to.
Some of these guys should start getting, as Jeff Green called them in his LP, loser killed before too long.
I'm guessing that's for those that get the losers that keep dying in the same spot.
He was really bad.
Yeah.
It kind of got unwatchable, and I stopped about quite a ways in, actually, I guess in the grand scheme of things. But and then he gave up on and switched to Bloodborne.
And thankfully for all of you watching, you will never get that bad an experience here because Wayne will take over.
Yeah.
Yay, Wayne!
No, you don't get it really bad.
There we go.
Moxie certainly does in the Bastille. So I'm guessing Pursuer pops up more than just the one time in... Because I ran into him at the... like right at the start of it, when you like right after the first pursuer, you say the bottom of that first dungeon, I guess, the first cell, he pops up right there where the coveted silver ring is.
Let's see, it's through here.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah, even the animation puts the torch away, you get it right back.
That's
so
good.
Yeah. All right.
Leggings!
We've almost got a full Varangian set.
If I wanted to cosplay as them, I totally could.
Then I'd go and heal up just on the safe side.
Fair enough.
Pretty hard section here.
And I guess there's no reason to keep the torch around.
So. Right. Yeah, you might get close enough to make him pull the swords and then back away. I think he should chase you at that point.
There we go.
Yeah, okay. Now you got him. And now you're mine. Well, if it wasn't for that pesky door, the door jam.
Walls? How dare you? Okay. Now for this guy.
Not a fan of the Varangian set there.
He can't hit me.
Yeah, it's not bad in terms of how like light armor is in this game. You know, the cloth armor and stuff. You know, the no poise, everything. But it's really kind of underwhelming. Oh, nice counter hit there.
That and it was a fire arrow.
Ah.
Okay.
Okay, then yeah, that'll look. Yep. If at all possible, you don't want to fight anybody in that actual room. I have had that the treasure chest in there broken like half the times I've played this game. Nothing. Did another guy pop out of the doorway there? Yeah, there he is.
And did he actually follow me?
He might not be.
Huh.
Okay, he's getting closer. There we are. You know, I wonder if, now that we have the lightning spear, after we're done with this area, we might want to go back to the very first zone, you know, Things Betwixt, and get the stone ring from killing the hippo cyclops.
Oh yeah, we could probably do that now.
Yeah, and get some extra poise damage against these guys. Oh, okay, so just a titanite shard. I don't feel so bad now. Seriously, every time. Then
down.
Go down. Yep.
All
right. There's, I think, another treasure chest in here. Oh, and more Varangians. Oh, a whole bunch of Varangians. Luckily, they do not wake up for anything until you attack them directly, it looks like. Or break their table. I don't know how they didn't kill him, or how they didn't hit him on those shots.
Good question. Okay.
Oh, Fox saying the saddest chest story is dying to a mimic and having it then die to poison to make him lose whatever it dropped. Oh, that sucks. Yeah, I was starting to think it would have still been there, but that's only for like NPCs and stuff, not mimics. Oh, that's harsh. I was starting to wonder why you were getting so many hits for like 200 when I think the average was around like 130 or whatever. I think it's because their attack frames are so long that you'd usually get a counter hit. Yeah, their attack frames are long and they start early, I'm guessing, right, is what's going on there.
That would probably make sense, yeah.
Yeah, good call. Good thought there. You can also break open the shutters on the window so let some light in. There's no torch here, but...
Go over here.
Uh-huh. Hmm. It doesn't make much difference unless you turn the light on outside, but...
And the treasure chest, which has...
Oh, Fox looked it up. It didn't look like he missed anything.
A Brigand set.
The Brigand set is really light and has decent resistances, so it's not bad. Of course, the axe will probably never use because it's strength-based, right. But... Okay, now you don't need to go this way unless you really want to kill some dogs, or you want to use a Pharaoh's Lockstone to set up the huge, basically just to light the lighthouse, basically.
Well, as I don't think we actually have a Pharaoh's Lockstone on call, there's no reason to.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So back we go, I guess.
Uh-huh. I think there are some. I think there might be like a drop or two out there, but yeah, it's not really worth it.
Fair enough.
And I can always come back later if we need it.
Okay, so what now?
All right, go back. And at this point, the only thing left, really, is the boss.
I guess we can go ahead and try it out.
Yeah. We have two Estus, we have the Lasso and Life Gems, we have Lightning Spear. Okay, yeah. Sounds good. That's not bad.
Okay.
The Lightning Spears will help out a lot for reasons they'll become... Okay, down the...
Oh!
Yeah, that's the guy guarding the lighthouse.
Down,
yeah, down there. Yeah, a nice way to arrest your fall there. Then all the way to the boat. There is an NPC. You can kind of see him over on the right there. But we have to have 10 int to talk to him. He's a sorcery trainer in this game.
Oh, yeah.
So yeah, he won't.
Yeah, I remember that guy.
Yep, Carillion. He won't even move to Majula.
Oh, I remember this fight.
Yep. There's one less Varangian in this part, and I think there's one fewer on the shore, or on the wharf, too, to come after you. So it's not as bad. It is funny how they made some fights harder and then some easier. Okay, so they're all coming. Because we didn't kill any of them this time.
How dare you block?
At least the rest of his men were like, yeah, screw that guy. We didn't like him anyway. And just let him fight you on his own. Or on the... Yeah, they let him fight you on his own.
Let's see. There's one more. Oh, but he's running away. Okay, that's good.
Peace. That's great.
Is that someone we need to fight?
That is an enemy. You could probably run past them, but...
Actually, I'm thinking that with the amount of Estus this is costing, I should probably just run back to the bonfire and try again.
And then just run your way here?
Right.
Okay.
Should be... Trying to keep my eyes open for that Varangian in case he came back.
Right.
Will all of them rush back over here? Or just, like, a group of them?
All the ones on the pier will come after you. There's, I think, three hiding there, and there's one or two from the first area. I think all of them will aggro if you haven't killed any of them. But since you've already... I think that the water is safe on that side anyway, but... Oh.
Well, why did that not get afraid of the fire? I guess it was used to it by now?
Yeah.
It does solve the question, though. They do not
attack each other. Yeah, which is ridiculous, right?
Right.
They have the mechanic in there for enemies to attack each other, but I guess they just decided not to use it.
Right. I guess by now they decided that, you know, they're good enough neighbors to not worry about it. Okay.
I would just not even bother with mud, run straight across a shortcut, grab the bloodstain, and see if you can get to the boat without any clearly.
Okay.
Because you don't actually have to fight anybody on deck. No, the other way.
Well, my thought was, you know, I'm going to have the two Varangians right here.
Well, if you go the other way, you'll have the dog and another Varangian, the one from the archer.
Okay. All right.
Run!
I can.
Yeah, basically, run for the boat. As soon as you get up on deck, of your right, and down, just straight ahead.
Okay.
And if you keep going down, you can go straight to the boss.
Ah. And the fog. Mm-hmm. Or the mist.
Yes.
Okay.
Here we go. And yeah, there's a mechanic here that is really helpful for a faith-based character. The enemies in water will take extra damage from lightning.
So I might as well just throw everything I've got at him right at the start.
That's not a bad initial spike of damage, too. And then as far as I know, this guy doesn't have any tricks like getting tougher as the fight progresses or anything like that. Well, that's a lot of damage.
Yep, he's doing a lot.
Looks like it might actually be weak to thrust with how much damage I was doing compared to the lightning bolts. Ooh. Yeah, there you go. I would go ahead and top off, just because you don't move within range of one combo hit of dying.
Right.
And if he did kind of bang the drums on you. This is, you know, you remember how last time somebody said one thing that's important to do is to roll into attacks? If he does that thrust attack, you can roll through it and get a hit on him with the roll stab. Yeah. I find the barb to club end is more manageable than that, unless he does that jumping swing. It will pretty much never hit you. It knocks you down if he does, but... Yeah, I like how they have that system to kind of rotate their sides against you. Oh, you almost got him. One combo will do it. So I have to make sure not to... Looks like you got some hyper armor for dodging there.
There
we go. Nice.
The first boss I've killed on my first try. Yay! Victory!
In one of the oddest comments I'm probably going to hear this stream, Mog says he's very disappointed to discover you can't drown. No, but yeah, you can actually see that the water rises throughout the fight, and I think it rises higher in Scholar. Yes, that's back where we started.
Well, I just wanted to make sure there wasn't anything down here. But it doesn't look like it, and he's not aggroing, so...
Yep. I should give you a yay.
Yay! Thank you, Mog.
But yeah, the water does rise, but it stops at about waist height. Now, while you're in there, it slows you down and uses up more stamina to roll through. But other than that, it's just cosmetic.
Right.
Do not use that. Open up the chest first.
Do not use the astrolabe.
Yep. Because I'm pretty sure I don't know if you can get back in here. You might be able to have to go around and use the ship again. But there we go. There's our pyromancy. Now you can. Yeah, it does get...
La campagna.
It does
get... Queremos que irnos. Lord Sadler. For those of you who missed our Resident Evil 4 LP, I apologize. Yep.
Oh, he's no longer glowy. Uh-huh. Yeah, pre-rendered cutscenes, I guess. Well, not pre-rendered, because he has the proper attire, but...
Oh, so Fox, you did have to go all the way back to open that chest.
Ooh, I'm glad to know that you can, however... Right.
That's the thing, it's like, you know, it's a pain, but it's a lot better than saying, oh, no, you just don't get your pyromancy form.
Right.